Welcome everybody to Rapture Watch for Sunday the 16th of December 2018. Watchman on the Wall, William from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. And I hope all of you guys are having a blessed day in the Lord. And today I wanted to share with you right out of the gate something that became aware of my attention yesterday, that the videos, I usually end with a song called Call Upon the Lord, and I play that because of Romans chapter 10, verse 13, which I always love to play at the end of the video, and to encourage everybody who may not have called upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that they would do so. And it's a way for me to share the gospel at the end of the video. Knowing that now I have received a tag or a strike per se, because I don't monetize my videos, that it will now have an advertisement ahead of it. So I wanted to ask your guys' opinion. I could have done this in a poll, but if you want me to remove that, all music, all things that are not copy, third-party copywritten, let me know so that I can take it out, because I don't want to feature advertisements on these videos, whether it be for a third party or for any other reason. I believe that I freely have received and I freely give, and that's my point of view. I don't condemn brothers and sisters who want to monetize. That's up to them. I believe for myself that storing up treasures in heaven is more important than laying up treasures on earth, and I've always believed that. And like I said, I freely give what I have freely received, and so I don't like advertising. And I also feel that song, it means a lot to me. I love that song. I was looking for a track that had Jesus' name in it, because a lot of songs, worship songs, they'll just have God. And I feel like, you know, some people are writing songs that are very generic and just putting God in there and not saying Jesus Christ. So that's why I love that song, because I asked God to send me a song that I would love to listen to and worship with his name. And that's the song I found over 2 years ago now. And I love that song. And it's unfortunate that the band kind of hit me with a tag, but I know that they'll hit me with one every single time now. And either it's YouTube or it's their record label or whatever. I've already gone on too far along about this, but the point of the matter is, I want your opinion, whether you guys want me to take out the song at the end, or just what you think. So, anyways, today's Sunday, and we are having a family supper here, so I can't really talk for very long, but I wanted to just let you guys know today, you know, how much the Lord loves you, and how much that, you know, we have to be thankful for every single thing that we have, and all the people in our lives. I was feeling negative a couple days ago, and God really put so much perspective in my spirit. And about two Christmases ago, I think it was the 2016 Christmas. I went away from my family and I felt that I needed to get away and be independent. And I've always been with my brother and mom at Christmas time. And this particular year, I lost a lot of weight. I was trying to do like a self-help thing. I wasn't focused on the Lord. I was very about myself and selfish. And I went on this trip and I was so sad. And so I felt so out of place. And the people I was with were so hospitable and did so much to try and involve me. And I felt out of place and wrong. And this year, with mom being sick and us moving to this new house, my brother's been around a lot lately. I'm back in my part of town. And, you know, I grew up in Acadia and now I'm in Willow Park. I feel so lucky and so blessed. And I know the Lord is bringing us together for Christmas. And I feel good about that. And I don't ever want to experience not being around my family at Christmas time ever again. And Lovey was with me. He's with me right now, actually. He came with me on the trip. And it was nice that I had him with me. But no, I just want to explain to you guys that no matter how you feel about family at Christmas time, cherish every moment that you have with them. And don't neglect the gathering of each other. And you know, it's so important that we gather together either online or in person with people and just tell them that they're loved and hug them. And especially at this time of year, we're able to spread the gospel way more easier with Christmas songs and you know, depending on like whatever you feel about this time, we can celebrate any day. We don't have to follow the traditions of men. We can celebrate any day. And so I want you guys to not look at Christmas negatively. Look at this as a extended Thanksgiving and a celebration of the birth of our Lord. And you know, enjoy the songs, enjoy the your family, enjoy the time, and don't let, you know, the lies of the world and what they have turned this into and what it used to represent, don't let that ruin the Holy Spirit that is everywhere at this time. And I know it's getting less and less every year, but as Christians, let's keep the Holy Spirit alive. And, you know, to the non-believers, they call it the Spirit of Christmas, but we know it's the Holy Spirit of God. And we pray for peace and for us to be together. And I know I pray for you guys, and I thank you guys for listening to these every day. I know sometimes they're just rambling on, but I want you to know that I love you and you're not alone, and that, you know, keep watching, keep looking up, get excited for your life for today. Only worry about today. Don't worry about tomorrow. Don't worry about yesterday. Today is all we got. And as long as you can make a difference today, that's all that matters. And so if I don't see you guys tonight, then I will have another message for you very soon. Have a wonderful Sunday, guys. I love you, and peace be with you.